everyone, Megan here from MeganMins.com, and today I'm going to show you how to create and manage your content calendar using Asana. By following these simple steps, you'll have a content calendar that makes it so easy for you to create content consistently for your business. The first step is to create a new project in Asana for your content calendar. You could just name it Content Calendar, or if you want to get more specific, feel free. Since I do YouTube videos every Thursday, mine is called YouTube Videos. I have a podcast one, and that's called Podcast. Could say blog posts, or you could just leave it at Content Calendar. Whatever works for you. Just go ahead and make that project and name it, and then Asana will ask you to choose between a board or a list. Now, this is a new feature. At the time I'm recording this, Asana just rolled out the boards feature where you can either have your projects as lists, which is what Asana used to only offer, or now you can have boards, which are more visual columns, and it's really great for those processes where a visual element is helpful. So make sure you choose board instead of list, because that's what I'm going to be showing you through this process. Now that you have your project created, I'm going to guide you through creating 5 columns within this board. The first one should say to write, or it could say to record if this is a video or a podcast. The second column should say to edit. The third column should say to schedule / publish. Column 4 should say to promote. And column 5 should say published. Step number 2 is to create a new task, and it will be your template. So we're gonna build out a template for every piece of content. So for me, I do YouTube videos, so I have a process that I go through for every single video I create. If you have a blog or you do a podcast, I'm sure you have your own process as well. So we're gonna go ahead and build that out. So create a new task, call it template, and make sure you put this new task in the first column on your board. You're going to use this over and over again, so you wanna make sure it stands out and it's right at the beginning of your process. Now go in and flush out all of the steps that go into your process. I like doing this in the subtasks of this template, and go ahead and really flush this out. Copy and paste if you already have this document in somewhere else. Don't forget to fill out the description and anything else that you need to help make this process as easy as possible. And in case you aren't sure how to get started with a content process, maybe you don't have anything documented or you don't have a process down, don't worry, I've got you covered. I actually have a free content process checklist template in the link below this video, so you can download it and start with this and then customize it for you, your business, your team, and your content. Now that you have your template task created, we're going to use this as a template for every piece of content you want to create. So just go ahead and open up that template task, click the 3 dots in the right corner, and then select make a copy. This is how you're going to use something as a template over and over again. Now name the new task the name of your content. So maybe it's the title of your blog post or the name of your video or the podcast episode, whatever is helpful, even just a topic if that's all you know so far. Then go ahead and make the due date the date this piece of content gets published. This is just a really great reference point, so at a glance you can see when it really needs to be done by. Then go ahead and assign it to yourself or assign it to your content manager. I am my business's content manager, so it's totally fine if this is all just you. You don't have to assign it to other people, but by still assigning these things to you, it's going to be really top of mind. It's going to be in your task list every day. So definitely go through the step of assigning it to you or whoever is managing your content process. Don't forget to give the subtasks due dates and assignees as well based on your process. I know for my team, I have a video editor and I have a virtual assistant. So most of the tasks are on me to write the script, record, upload, schedule the blog post, all that good stuff. But I do have a team that is helping me along the way. So make sure you're assigning content and tasks to whoever is supposed to do them on your team. So now you have your content calendar built out in Asana, way to go you, but I do have a few pro tips to help make this process even easier and seamless. Make sure you keep it up to date, especially if you are the only person on your team or you are your content manager. If you let these tasks go out of date and you're not updating them or marking them complete, this process will fall apart. That goes with any project management system and any process. But specifically for this, we want this process to work for you. So make sure you're checking in every day, marking tasks complete as you've done them, changing due dates if you need to give yourself a little extension. All that's totally fine, but just make the effort to go in and keep it updated. Another tip is to get detailed. Write out all the information that you and your team need within these tasks. I think mine always has like the actual, in the description, I'll have the time things are getting published. I will put the full title. I'll put what the content upgrade is. Any important information, I put that in the description. And I'm always attaching files. Part of my process is updating a spreadsheet with certain links, whether it's the YouTube link or the blog post link or the content upgrade landing page. So I actually attach that Google Drive spreadsheet into the relevant task. And then it's just really easy for us to do it. You can just click it right from within Asana. You don't have to open up Google Drive separately. So get detailed, and it's okay if this process kind of like evolves as you're doing it. That's great. That's really actually ideal. This will evolve with you and your process. But go ahead and get as specific as you can right now. You also want to make sure that you and your team are communicating within Asana. Now, if you have a system like Slack set up, I understand it's sometimes easier to communicate in there, and that's okay. But for task-related questions, we have a really good policy about communicating in the task. It's just a great reference point. We can always go back and see what that conversation was. It's stored in a more permanent way than Slack, where if unless you're paying, which I always do the free version, some of those messages will go away. I think you have 10,000 messages in Slack, but you get the point. Keeping it in Asana is just a great way to always have a reference point of what the answer was and to update the process and just keep it all within Asana. We want to avoid using emails for, you know, internal communication as much as possible. And the last tip I have for you is to designate a content manager. I kind of touched on this earlier, but even if it's just you, making that official designation that you are the content manager, or your virtual assistant is your content manager, or you have hired a content manager, whoever it is, designate it, because that person is the one who's going to move the task throughout this workflow. So we made those original columns, and someone needs to be making sure that they're moving, you know, to record, to edit, to publish. Someone needs to move through that process. That's the person who the task has probably been assigned to. And then also just making sure things are getting done, holding your team accountable for due dates, holding you accountable for your due dates. I totally get how easy it is to forget about them sometimes. But designating a content manager, even if it's just you, will give you new authority and new ownership over your content process. Now you know how to create and manage a content calendar using Asana. But if you don't have a process set up right now for creating content, you're starting from zero. That's why I'm sharing my exact content creation process with you as a worksheet. Don't forget to download the content creation process below this video so you can start creating content consistently right away. Now I wanna hear from you. How do you manage your content calendar process right now? Leave your tips in the comments below this video. If you thought this video was helpful, be sure to subscribe, share it with your friends, and hit the like button below so I know to make more videos like this. I'll see you in the next one. Create content and give yourself a head start. Process worksheet for you that you can get in creating consistent content right now, right away. If you thought this video was helpful, share it with your friends.